Are your dreams bigger than the moment when things get extremely hard? That saved my life. My dream is here. This is the train. This is the zone. I do this every day. I don't do this when I wake up and I'm winning. I do this when I'm losing also. I do this every day. I do this on Sunday. Every day, this train does not stop. It is a one-way, it's a one-way track. I have a one-way track mind, guys. It runs that way. Guys, it's all good. There's nothing negative in it. It's positive all the way. But this light is my dream. What's your dream? Everybody right now, write it down. What's your dream? And by the way, some of you, it may be, I don't know. It truly may be, I don't know. Like that may be your dream. See, you may have already hit it. You need a new one. One of the cool things I love about my wife is that we're able to keep dreaming every day. It never ends. One of the craziest things that has allowed us to keep moving is how crazy our dreams get. And when we shared our dreams with other people, you know what they told us? You're stupid. So we stopped sharing them. 2018, I'm sitting in a dealership, made $2.5 million being a GM. The owner told me that I was making too much money because I took a store from making $1 million to $12 million. And he said that he never envisioned paying anybody that much. And I said, well, I never envisioned you making that much either. So, but he said, well, I mean, it's just, you know, we just think we're paying you too much. Surely you can understand. So he talked to me about what he thinks I should make. I shook his hand and I walked away. He called me back the next day and he said, no, we'll keep your pay the same. I said, off. I started my own business and I went all in. Listen to me. He called me 3 days later and he said, I'll pay you more. I'll pay you more than you were making. Why would somebody with me? Why? You know why? Because people get greedy. Don't ever get greedy. Understand this, okay? Every single person in this room, guys, it's not about money. It's about making an impact. You know the reason why we're able to sell so many cars and make so much money in that dealership was because I love my people. That's why. My people that work for me all average 30 grand a month. They made a lot of money and I loved watching them win. That's all I cared about. I'm going to tell you this, all right? You're made for something great. And by the way, I was the worst salesman in the history of time and I was able to do a lot of this stuff. Most of the successful people that you look up today were living out of their car, okay? One of the things that I do whenever I go to study somebody, number one, I see how great they are today, but I want to know the backstory. I want to know it. Where did they come from? Did they have money? And I get excited about that shit. I don't want to know how much, hey, my company's making $200 million now. Not really interested in that. Tell me what happened when you were living in your car. How did you get out of that? You see, because that's the life lesson. Does that make sense? Some of you guys in here, you've been to prison before. You've been to jail. You understand time more than anybody else. Stop wasting it. You promised when you get out, you were going to give everything you had. I went to jail one day in my life. It was awful, okay? It was awful. I am telling you right now, all you need is one little taste of something to remind you that, man, this is what I need. By the way, if anybody in here really wants to really go to the next level, just go to a nursing home. Seriously. No. Go into a nursing home and walk in there because right now you're wanting to start your own business. You guys got your own deal. And by the way, some of you guys in here have reached mad amounts of success. Do you know there's a lot of people in here that have a lot of money in the bank? And they're still in here training? Guys, listen, I just spent 30 grand going to a Patrick Bet David event in Miami with me and my wife, 30,000 for training for 3 days. I'll never stop. My money means nothing. I care about me and her, the way that we think, what we're able to do. How great are we? Okay, how great is my team? Am I giving them the tools that they need to succeed? I want you to think about this, right? How do you scale and grow? How do you guys move? Well, how you move, the biggest part is you gotta have a dream. You gotta have something that makes you want to wake up and go. There's a saying that I say that I sleep with my shoes on, okay? And what that means is that I literally sometimes don't want to take them off because I'm so excited to get them back on in the morning and go. One of the things that I have to do is slow down because I want to win so much. I never take for granted 1 second. Go into a nursing home and go ask them, say, hey, I want to ask you, so obviously you're here, it's the end of your life, right? I mean, this is your final destination the next couple years. Whatever. Do you feel like, don't say that. I was just joking. I'm thinking though, that this is probably where they're gonna hang out until they go meet Jesus, okay? So I'm like, I would say something like, so tell me about your life, right? Do you have any regrets? And most of the time, massive amounts. You'll see tears break into the eyes, okay? Because they didn't go get what they wanted. I will tell you guys this, as we're sitting here today, we're gonna train like crazy, but I need you to have that gratitude, that gratefulness inside of you, and that fire in you. And by the way, listen, no one else is gonna keep that fire in you, no one. Bradley, no one's gonna get that fire in you. When you leave right now, understand this, what I'm telling you is what I tell myself every morning. What I tell my team every morning. You wanna be like this? Steal it. Done. Now it's yours. You own it. Become a badass.